Hi guys, I've got the shutters half lowered here in the kitchen, which is normal for August here in France, when people tend to close their shutters for the whole month pretty much. And have to keep out the heat, and also they may go away, and we do it for security purposes. I am making this clip standing here right now, showing you the kitchen that I'm about to clean, because I've noticed that today I noticed black objects flying in the kitchen. And they looked sort of like insects, but there was nothing there. And I don't know what's going on. I don't know if this is paranormal. You can hear my voice. I haven't smoked since June, people. I bought 2 packs of cigarettes since then, and I smoked them, and I enjoyed them. But I'm doing way better on the cigarette front, and I feel very fragile right now, and I've posted a clip about problems in my marriage and how sad I am here in France. But I don't know what's going on with this. You know, the last time I saw this was like 4 minutes ago, 5 minutes ago here, and I thought that's weird. I should surely have my eyes checked again. And I do that here a lot in France, and I'm covered for it. And I don't wear glasses every day. I'm losing my eyesight, actually. I'm going blind. I took Braille lessons and everything to prepare me. And I had a visitor here in 2008 who promptly destroyed my computer keyboard. And it was a Braille keyboard. And under French law, you don't have to tell your spouse when something is wrong with you, like physically. So when I had liver cancer in 2007, I was not obligated to tell my husband, and I didn't. And, you know, for the blindness thing, this is connected with being put on cortisone for years as a kid in the United States after being having my immune system compromised due to a polio vaccine in 1963 when I was in Cleveland, Ohio. And when I was 5 years old, and I spent a lot of my childhood unable to walk and of limited mobility, and quite some period of time in a wheelchair. And I was also sent to a public hospital to die, and my parents were forbidden to see me except for, you know, I think it was like once a month, which was actually the practice also in England until the 1970s, because for children 5 years and under, it was considered too traumatic for them to see the parents. And this is really true, people. You know, when you have little kids and they're very sick and you go to see them, you may not be helping them. I know nobody wants to hear this, but the separation anxiety that the children develop is really something that they will carry with them for the whole rest of their lives. So really once a month for a few hours is about right. You know, I'm a former nanny, and believe me, the kids, the babies and everything, you know, yeah, they cry when mommy and daddy go off to work in the morning, but, you know, 10 minutes later, they are easy to distract, and they don't think about them anymore, and you guys don't have to worry about that, because at the end of the day, when you come home, your child does not see the nanny anymore. He or she ceases to exist for them, and they only have eyes for their biological parents pretty much all of the time. And it's beautiful to see. And like Mary Poppins, I used to love it. I used to freaking love it. And I was glad to give the kids back clean and well-fed and well-cared for every day and let their parents deal with the long-term stuff. You know, I kind of got to rent the kids and got paid for it. You know what I mean? That was generally a fairly good experience. Fairly good. You know, there were some limits on that. All right, people, so these are some of my thoughts, and I don't know about these black things I see flying around in the kitchen. It's probably nothing, since I'm not wearing my glasses. I may be having, you know, sometimes I lose my eyesight almost entirely, and I have lost it entirely in one eye, which was pretty scary. But this is what we have to face when you get put on steroids, okay? When you're on cortisone. Oh, I hate when people say, okay. Sorry, I just did that. You know, so when you go on these things, you know, please think about it. It's going to have ramifications. It's going to have an effect on your body. And I'm 56 now, and I've always known that my eyesight is deteriorating, and people do notice that, really, you know, I can't see a lot of things. And right when I get my eyes checked every couple of years here in France, you know, the eye guy says, "Ah, cortisone." It's usually a man. You know, cortisone, you know, they see it right away. They see the damage, you know. So think carefully about giving your kids vaccines and taking any steroids and stuff. So, on the paranormal front, I really had a nice visit recently in England for one day, and I met Steve Clemenson and his wife Leslie. And they are documenting paranormal stuff, and they've been at it for a long time. And their experiences are quite extraordinary, and they're both able to be very specific about dates and times and stuff, and there are other witnesses, and they have tried to record things as much as they could, which they couldn't do that much before. I understood. I have had a spectacular UFO experience here in France with my husband and many locals here in my community in 2002. But I did not own this digital camera yet. So I couldn't record it, and I was just downtown to see a movie, you know, really. All right. Be well, people, and, you know, thanks for putting up for me and with me, and thanks for your support, and probably the two little black objects I saw were nothing, but I'm going to look at this video later and see if anything turns up on this, because I have one up from about February of 2011 where I was pointing the camera outside the window. And I was talking about the moon and an anomaly I had seen the month before. And I ended up recording an orange pyramid in the sky. And I still can't explain it. You know, if that's a camera glitch, it's pretty fabulous, you know. I don't know. I don't know what to think about that. I don't know. I really don't know. So be well, people. And, some of you have been asking for cooking videos, and I'm just not up for that. I'm very sad about my marriage right now. And I've got some rice cooking here. And onions and tomatoes cooking, and we're gonna have some steak. And yeah, I wrapped it in foil. I don't like things wrapped in aluminum, and I don't like things wrapped in plastic, but I'm stopping that. Okay, bye.